Whoa!
We hope you guys had an epic Father's Day last week.
Yeah, I really hope you guys enjoyed your Father's Day challenges.
Yes, and Wanga.
Yeah, what's up?
Speaking of challenge.
Oh, it is that time. Okay, yep. What do you have for me today?
Okay, there is good news for today.
Good news.
Today's challenge is for both of us.
Yes, so we both get to eat gross things. It's a lot better than eating gross things alone.
Do you think that I would ever make myself eat bad things?
Oh, it's you. So we are both eating good things.
That's it.
Okay, cool.
Well,
what are we doing?
Depends, but we'll see.
Yeah, okay.
Okay, so as you can see, we have a lot of cups.
Okay.
Which can only mean one thing.
Are we eating cups?
Wanga! No, we are not eating cups.
Okay.
We are gonna play Stack Attack.
Stack Attack! I'm ready, let's go!
What? What are you doing?
We Stack Attack.
No, Wanga, that's not how it works. Okay, let me explain.
Okay.
We've each got 12 cups over here.
Okay.
And we're gonna make a pyramid, stacking them up.
Okay.
And whoever can do it in the shortest amount of time
wins.
Time gets a stack of pancakes.
Pancakes! Pancakes!
So he is excited. Yes. I'm excited. I really hope I win.
Yeah, I'm gonna win.
Because I need the pancakes.
Yeah.
Okay. So, also, there are two rounds.
Okay.
And the second round has a...
It's a twist.
Yep.
There's always a twist with Lauren.
There's always a twist. Okay,
okay,
so you ready for round one?
Okay, I am so ready. Let's go.
Put your cups together like this.
Okay.
And 3, 2, 1, go. Okay, I'm totally gonna win this. This is really hard.
This is so easy for me. I am on 4 and you're still on 3.
I got 4 now. Okay. It's so hard.
Okay. Let me just wait for her while she takes the time.
Okay. No, don't say that. Okay. I am totally winning.
Oh, wow. You see? Wait.
I'm totally good.
Lauren,
totally
so stop.
Win.
I need to tell you a story.
No,
story.
Don't just.
No. I messed it up.
Okay.
Wait.
Boom.
Okay. Lauren wins that round.
I win.
But I am definitely going to win the next round.
Yes. Okay, guys, that was a lot harder than I thought it would be.
Yeah, it is actually.
Okay, ready?
Okay. Okay, so for round two, we're gonna leave the cups like this.
But the twist.
Oh, I forgot the twist. There's a twist.
We are gonna do this blindfold.
Okay, I'll add my own twist. The tower must be the tallest for you two.
So whoever gets
finishes first and has the tallest tower
wins.
Yeah.
Okay, let me just. My glasses.
So two twists, double twists. Okay, I'm ready to stack.
Okay, me too. Where's the table? Okay,
cameraman.
Here's the table. Okay.
Okay.
Cameraman,
count
you
down.
Have to count us down and tell us who wins. All right.
All right. 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay. Okay, relax, Wanga. Relax.
Okay. Lauren, relax. Okay, I'm gonna so beat you, Wanga.
What's going on? I can't see a thing.
I can't
help
see.
Help me.
Where is it? Okay, let me put it. Okay, let me. Where's
Yo,
the cup?
I hope I don't hit it. Okay.
The tower.
Okay, cameraman, how many do I have left?
Okay, I only have 2 cups.
I have one.
Where's
I'm done.
Tower?
I win.
Really? No ways.
Am I winning, cameraman?
I'm done. I think I'm done.
I'm done. I finished fast.
Oh, good luck.
You know, one is not on. Wait, if I do this. Wait.
Oh no. Oh. Okay, guys. I am the champion.
No, you're not.
Dum. I get.
Okay, I give it to Lauren. You win. You get the pancakes,
but
the Bible speaks about sharing is caring. So
no, it doesn't say that.
Yes, it says that. Jesus shared with people.
Not in those exactly words.
Yeah, but similar.
Okay, fine. I'll share. And we'll
share
with our amazing cameraman.
Okay, cool.
Okay,
yes.
Awesome. So we're going to get into our Bible story for today.
Yeah.
Well, first we're going to do some worship.
Yeah.
And then get into our Bible story, which actually has some stacking in it. okay? It might not be stacking of cups.
Yeah.
And it's definitely not a stack of pancakes.
Okay.
But, hey, why don't you guys actually guess
okay.
what they're going to stack in okay, our Bible story?
Are they stacking socks? Are they stacking no. other things? Chocolate?
No.
Actually, I actually know what
you,
it is.
You just really nice things.
Yeah, I actually know what it is.
Okay.
But I'm not going to let you guys know for now because we're going to go into worship and then Bible story. And
Let's
then
do
you're
going
to find out.
Let's do it.
Okay, ready? No, love you like that. Love me like
he's
that.
He's super excited. I'm going to pray first. Okay.
Oh, yeah. Let's pray.
Jesus, we thank you so much that we can have fun together
yeah.
on Sundays like this. We thank you that nothing can stop your church.
Mm-hmm.
We thank you that though we cannot meet together in a physical place, we know that where two or more are gathered,
yeah.
you are there.
Yeah.
So thank you that you are with us in our homes right now.
Mm.
Thank you that we can laugh and experience your joy
yeah.
In moments like this. And God, we really pray that you would teach us from your word this morning, that we would grow closer to you,
yeah.
that we would understand in all its goodness
yeah.
and all its fullness
yeah.
what you have done for us. Father, I pray that our hearts would be open to learn, that
yeah.
we would be young boys and girls who grow mature and strong in your love.
Come on.
That nothing would shake us, that we would be immovable for your kingdom.
Yeah.
In Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen. Wow, awesome. That was a powerful prayer.
Let's go.
I am so ready worship. For worship. Now
worship,
I'm going to sing.
Worship,
no,
worship,
man, love
worship.
Me like that. Love
you're
me like that.
One.
You're the only
love
one
like
who can
that.
Love like that. And guitar.
I was wrong when I walked away. I went too far. I forgot your face. Now bring my heart back to your embrace. Oh, oh, I wanna know ya. I get so tired living on my own. Now all I want is to come back home. All I want is to hold you close. Oh, oh, I wanna know ya. Have all of my life, you are my love. Can't get enough. Stop me now. Oh, I wanna know. You're the only one who can love me like that.
nothing you won't do. No place that I could hide. You're always in pursuit. I'm never too far gone. Always in your side. When I wait for you, you're always right on time. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. You made a way for me, opened up the door. Jesus, you have my heart, now and forevermore. You're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. In me, you're always pursuing, always pursuing, always pursuing me. Oh, your love is chasing, your love is chasing, your love is chasing me. More than the air I breathe, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. More than the air I breathe, yeah, I need you here with me. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop. And you're never gonna stop, never gonna stop chasing me. No, you're never.
Man, worship was power.
Yeah.
Or should I say
epic? It was epic.
Yeah. Okay. So for our 1 minute conversation started, here is your question for today. What is your favorite memory?
What is your favorite memory? So take some time, 1 minute with the people in the room and answer that question. Go.
And go. Boom, boom, boom.
Welcome back, Lauren. We've had some incredible memories doing church online with our friends. It's been incredible. What are some of your favorite memories?
Okay, so I absolutely love the dance dice. Remember the dance dice?
10-second dance party!
10-second dance party! Quick!
Wow, that was a good one. That was a good one,
right? Yeah. And then remember when we did Mother's Day?
Yeah.
And we did the cake in a cup? That was actually a fail.
Yeah, that wasn't actually nice.
It really wasn't.
We had to eat it and pretend it was nice.
We were using our acting skills. Okay, what is a good memory?
Remember Easter? Easter.
Oh, with all the eggs. Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
You got so many eggs cracked on you.
Yeah, I got so many eggs cracked on me. I still smell like eggs.
Wonga.
Yeah?
Have you showered since then?
Yeah?
Guys, we need to help a friend out. We need to help a friend out. Please tell me you're joking.
Man, God has been so good to us over this season. And today we are learning about how the Israelites also remembered what God had done for them. And we're going to learn it through some of the stuff that they had to stack. They had to stack some...
No! Don't say it!
Oh, yeah.
Okay, remember, we're going to watch the Bible story and they have to find it.
Oh, yeah. So, Bible story.
Hey, kids. Are you ready for another epic true story? Buckle up, because here we go. Joshua was the leader of the Israelites. And God was going to use him to lead God's people into the Promised Land, a special place God wanted the Israelites to live. But to get there, they had to cross the Jordan River. It was the only thing standing in their way. But getting across the Jordan wasn't a simple swim across a pool. And even that can be scary sometimes. No, this was deep flowing water. And at the time of year, it was higher than normal. There was no way they could just walk across. Or could they? Among the Israelites, there were priests who carried something called the Ark of the Covenant in front of the people. This was a special and holy object that God wanted the Israelites to treat very carefully. God told the priest to carry the Ark of the Covenant into the river. As soon as the priest stepped into the water, it stopped flowing. The priest stood on dry ground as all the Israelites crossed to the other side. Once everyone had crossed and the priest stepped onto land, the water began to flow again. This was no ordinary walk. This was a big deal. So Joshua told 12 men to gather 12 rocks and build a tower. When the people asked what the rocks were for, Joshua explained that he wanted other generations to know what God had done for the Israelites. When they should have been stopped or destroyed, God helped them. Joshua wanted everyone to remember what God had done, so he built a monument. And just like Joshua and the Israelites, I can remember what God has done for me too.
Wow, what an amazing Bible story that was. But let's hold the brakes a bit before we get into that. Let's do a quick recap. What did we learn last week? We learned that we can spend time with God anywhere. Yes, that's it. Anywhere, because of what Jesus has done. He has allowed for us to spend time with God on the couch, at school, wherever we may be, because God is always with us, so we can spend time with him anywhere. And today, we are learning, today's big idea is that we can remember what God has done for us. We can always remember what God has done for us. So, you might have seen on the Bible story a whole lot of rocks stacked together, and we're gonna take each rock to represent something that we can remember about God's nature and character. Okay, are you ready? Sweet, but I'm gonna need your help. So we're gonna do it a countdown from 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Okay, so the first rock for me, and this is all in the Bible, the Word of God. This is all in the Bible in Joshua 3 and 4. So make sure you ask your parents to help you and you can read that throughout the week. So the first rock represents that we can always remember that God is with us. Okay, number 12, God is always with us. And that's so important because during this time, some of us might feel lonely. We might feel alone. And it's so important for us to always remember that no matter what the circumstances in life are, God is always with us. Okay, number 11. Are you ready? This one represents that God always keeps his promises. God always keeps his promises. I don't know about you, but I am sometimes really bad at keeping promises. Like, I would tell someone, I'll see you at 10, and I will be there at like 3 past 10. But God is not like that. When God makes a promise to us, he always keeps it, and we can always trust him in the promises that he gives us. So number 11, God always keeps his promises. Number 10, are you guys ready? This one is that we remember that God makes miracles. What does God do? He makes miracles. And it's so important, especially with everything that's happening around the world at this time with COVID-19 and everything else, because we can feel a little bit suffocated. What that means is that we can feel a little bit like, man, everything is just going wrong. But actually, we know that God makes miracles. So we can actually spend time in prayer, yes, and actually trust that God will make miracles. That we can trust that God can heal people that are sick. We can trust that God can do incredible things. So this week, you can practically do this in your life and just pray to God and say, God, we trust that you make miracles. So it's always important to remember that God makes miracles. And number 9, are you guys still with me? Okay, number 9 is that God cares for us. I got the rock. God cares for us. 2 weeks ago, we had Father's Day. And for some of you, it was quite an emotional time, especially for me, it was because of the relationship that I have with my dad. But when I remember God, I know that God cares for me, so I can always go to God as a father. So it's so important for you to remember that, that God does actually care for you. Okay, and number 8, I still got the count. Okay, number 8 represents that we can remember that God is faithful. Say, God is faithful. What that means is pretty much the same as God keeping his promises. He's faithful to do whatever he says he will do. And then the next one, okay, number 7. The number 7 is that we remember, get my stone, we remember to thank God. We remember to thank God. By a show of hands, wherever you might be right now, show me if you had something to eat today. Okay? Now, show me if you've taken a shower over the last couple of days. I know I said I didn't take a shower. Whoopsie. But it's so important for us to remember and thank God for what we have done. Because I look at my life, I'm like, some of the stuff that I have now, I never had before. And I can take those things for granted, but I need to always remember to thank God. So it's important to remember. Number 7, always remember to thank God. And number six, are you guys ready for it? Remember to obey. We remember to obey. It's so important that we remember to obey God. When God tells us to do something, when we read something in the Bible, we remember that it will always lead to a fulfilling life when we actually do what it says. Okay, and number 5, are you guys ready? 5 represents that we remember to tell others what God has done for us. We remember to tell others what God has done for us, because we can hold on to these things and say, well, it's just me, it's just me. But God calls us for something greater, which is always to tell people that he is good, that he has done incredible things for us. So what has God done for you? Remember that and tell other people about it as well, so that they could be encouraged. Okay, number four is that we remember to pay attention to what God is doing. So that's number 4. Remember to pay attention to what God is doing. Because God is always doing something. God is always up to something. And it's for us to come alongside him and ask, God, what are you doing? And always remember to pay attention to that so that we could walk in line with what God is doing. Number 2. Number 3. I got that wrong. My math could be wrong sometimes. But number 3. Are you guys ready? Number 3 represents that we remember that God keeps his promises. You remember number 11, we say God, remember number 11, we say God makes promises. God doesn't just say, hey, I promise I'm gonna be there. He always shows up. So God keeps his promises, and we need to always remember that. And number 2, we are almost there, guys. So close. Number 2 represents that we remember that God is great. Man, I look around. There could be like some incredible people that I love. I think Lionel Messi is great. He's probably the greatest soccer player to ever live. And I love him. But I know that when it comes to people and everything that I've seen, God is greater than anything else in the world. So it's always great for us to remember that He is great. He's greater than anyone that we know. And number one, can I hear one? The small is a little bit small, but this is probably the most important one. So don't judge it by its size. Okay, so number one is that we remember to praise God for what He has done. We remember to praise God for what He has done. And the greatest thing that God has done for us is sending His only Son, Jesus, to go and die on the cross for our sins so that we could be in a relationship with Him. So we need to remember that because it's an incredible thing that we are in a relationship with God. So and praise Him for it as well. So I've got my 12 stones and I think it's your turn now at home, not right now, but right after this, to also make your list of 12 things that you are remembering God for. So take some time this week and actually write some 12 things that God has done in your life. It will help you remember. So go and do it and it's gonna be amazing and incredible. So that's my 12 stones and they're also in the Bible. Go and write your 12 things.
Wanga, thank you so much for that incredible lesson. I love that those 12 things were the things that the Israelites kept remembering about God. God is so faithful and He loves each one of us uniquely and so incredibly much. And Wanga ended the last thing. He said the last one of these stones was that they would remember what God has done for them. And you know what the greatest thing that God has ever done for any person is that He sent Jesus as a sacrifice for our sins so that we could have life to the fullest with God, to be reconciled with Him. That means to come back together with God and have sin no longer have a hold on our lives anymore, to not be controlled by sin anymore. I don't know about you, but that sounds like the greatest news that I have ever heard in my life. God is so kind to us. He looked down upon us and He didn't leave us in a broken situation, in a helpless situation, but He sent help. He sent His one and only Son so that we could have life and life to the full. And all He asks of us is to actually just accept that, to believe that that is what He has done, to believe what Jesus has done for us, that He died and rose again and is now with God in heaven at His right hand. And all we have to do is say yes to that message. So now if you've never ever done it before, if you've never done it at church online, or if you've never done it at Ignite or Kids Ministry, wherever you guys are watching this from, I want to give you an opportunity to do that. We do this every week because we believe every moment God is working in our lives and it might be your moment today. So if you feel in your heart that you are so drawn to God and you want to say yes and you want to start this new journey, pray this with me now. God, I recognize what You have done for me. The greatest thing that You have done for me is sending Jesus. Sending the Savior of the world to die on a cross for me so that I could have life. And today, Jesus, I accept Your love and Your life. I thank You that You have made me a new person. I thank You that I have gone from death to life, that I have gone from a separated relationship with God to one that is now totally with Him. You are so good to us, God, and I thank You for this moment. I pray that I would remember it for the rest of my life. In Jesus' name, amen. Hey, well done, friend. If that was you, if you gave your life to Jesus today, that is the best decision you will ever, ever make. And I want you to remember today for the rest of your life. Even if you maybe go home and write in your Bible, I gave my life to Jesus today, and write down the date so that when you speak to your friends, you can actually remember this day. We've been speaking about remembering. This is a day you don't want to forget. You will never, but it's good to reflect and write those things down. And for the rest of us, let's take some time out to remember what God has done for us. Maybe in this past week, maybe in our whole lives, let's just be grateful for the incredible things that God does for us. Okay, Wanga, thank you so much for an awesome message. Man, it was power. And
yeah.
I actually can't wait to take some time this afternoon at my house
yeah.
to just go and actually like remember what God has done for me.
Yeah, I feel the exact same way, Lauren. And I can't wait to remember what God has done for me while I snack on these.
Wanga.
Yeah?
Like, you do know that I won, right?
Yeah, but so sharing is caring. So just one.
Okay, I'll one-up you. I'll give you more than one. And I'll let you go first. Not all of them.
Oh, okay.
You can roll one.
Okay, I'll take one. Boom, 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 okay. Boom.
Boom, boom, boom. We have sanitizer here,
I can't wait
here,
to eat this pancake, guys. I've been waiting throughout, and I'm so excited.
I hope it tastes good.
It's going to taste good.
I spent all morning baking this.
Okay, sweet. Let's do it.
And how does it taste? Wanga. Wanga! Wanga! How does
Lauren,
it taste?
Who baked this?
Me!
Did you... You know you put salt instead of sugar? It tastes like salt. Like salt.
Like super salty.
Super salty.
Oopsie! That's my bad. Why are you having another bite?
I actually like salt.
Okay, it's well, really you can have all of these. Are you
yeah.
sure there's salt in there?
There's salt.
Or are you kidding me?
There's salt.
Okay, that's it from us for today, guys. We hope you had an amazing time and that you spend time remembering what God has done for you this week. Remember to visit our website so you can download our family packs to have faith and fun moments at home. But we will see you next week. Wanga la
out!
Bye!
Bye.